Sorting out teeth is something that comes up every now and again when you're doing portraits. By and large, we always expect teeth to be white, but to be honest, that's rarely the case. Particularly if somebody is a heavy smoker, tea drinker, a coffee drinker, then they often have a very distinct yellowy tone. So what I'm going to do here is to restore this chap's teeth to a nice pearly whites. Now, to do this, I need to first of all make a selection around his teeth. So I'm going to grab myself the freehand lasso and draw really around his gums, to be honest, or at least around his lips, around there. So I'm not being desperately accurate, but I'm just trying to limit it to the teeth area there. Let's zoom in nice and close. Now, to get this looking a nice pearly white teeth, I'm going to use an adjustment layer, a non-destructive method of working. So the black and white circle at the bottom, and I'm going to choose hue saturation. Now, in theory, I could just desaturate the image, but watch what happens. Remember that selection I drew a minute ago? Well, if I use the saturation slider, it'll work on the entire of the selection area. Now, his teeth are definitely no longer yellow, but nor was his lips or his tongue. So that's not exactly ideal, really, is it? Okay, let's just put that back where it was before, which was on zero. And instead, we're going to use the word master here, and clicking the down arrow next to it, I'm going to find the word yellows. So this will work on the yellow parts now, which really are his teeth. If I had dropped the saturation down this time, you'll see that his teeth are now desaturating in colour, but to a degree, so's his lips. They've gone slightly purple there. So again, it's not a perfect solution. So to get his teeth and nothing else selected, I'm going to hold down here. You see these little eyedroppers here? Hold the one that says the plus, or at least click on that one, and then run that across his teeth. Okay, just like that. Okay, lovely. So we get all those kind of yellow areas by clicking on them. Now that will help to work out on this little rainbow pattern down here which bits to change and which bits to leave. So now when I drop the saturation down, it should work just on his teeth. But for me, it's still picking up a bit of gum and a bit of face here. So I'm going to manually shift it. Can you see the red parts here? Now the red, of course, relates to skin tone. So I'm going to shift this in like so. As I do, you see it no longer affects the side of his face. To make sure that he's got pure white teeth, I could bump the lightness up. Again, it'll only work on the areas I've selected, and that will give him beautifully white teeth. It'll also look completely ridiculous because people don't have pure white teeth other than Hollywood stars or people that spend a lot of money at the dentist. It just wouldn't look right for this chap's face. So I'm actually going to bring it down so that his teeth are still slightly yellowed, but not a lot. Similarly, I'm not taking the saturation all the way down because again, that would give you the wrong look. A little bit of tone of colour is the right way to go. Remember, you're not trying to replace his teeth with pure white ones. You're merely trying to take away the appearance of yellow teeth. To know whether it's working or not, you can come down to the layer, switch the visibility icon, that's a little eye icon, on and off. So that's what we started with, and that's what we've ended up with, and that should be enough to give the look of nice white teeth, but without being so blindingly white that it's completely distracting.